Good morning, students. In the last class, we learned factorization by method of common factors. Now, let us today learn factorization by grouping terms. Let us see the problem. Let us take one algebraic expression.
Ax plus bx plus ay plus by. Can you observe, is there any common factor for these four terms? Ax plus bx plus ay plus by. Observe, is there any common factor for all the terms? No, there is no common factor for all the terms. So we can't proceed by the method of common factor. Now let us take, you can observe here, let us take the first two terms. What are the first two terms? Ax plus bx. What is the common factor of first two terms only? See, in the first two terms, x is a common factor. So, in the last two terms also, y is a common factor. So, by observing four terms, for first two terms, x is a common factor. Last two terms, y is a common factor. So, let us take grouping. We wanted the total expression divided into two subgroups. One is first two terms one subgroup, last two terms one subgroup. In the first two terms, let us take the common factor. By taking x common, what is the remaining factor in the first term? A. What is the remaining factor in the second term? B. In the last two terms, by taking y common, what are the remaining factors? A plus B. Now, again you can observe A plus B is a common factor. Now, by again taking A plus B as a common factor, what are the remaining factors? X plus Y. Now, this is the A plus B into X plus Y. These two are irreducible factors of this algebraic expression. Now, this is the factorization of this algebraic expression by grouping the terms. This problem we can do in the other way also. Can you think in the, what is the other way? By observing these four terms, first one, third one have common factor A. Let us take AX plus BX plus AY plus BY. See, AX plus AY. A is a common factor. Let us regrouping the terms. I am writing first term, third term. Second term, fourth term. Regrouping. So, the total four terms are added. So, we can write in the, by changing the order. And now, let us take, in the first two terms, A is a common factor. By taking A common, what are the remaining factors? X plus Y. The last two terms, what is the common factor? B. So, by taking B common, what are the remaining factors? X plus Y. Now, you can observe. X plus Y. X plus Y is a common factor. Again, by taking X plus Y common, now what are the remaining? A plus B. So, we can do this problem in two different ways. Now, let us take another problem. Here, observe, in these four terms, 6ab minus b square minus 2bc plus 12ac is an expression. In these four terms, what are the common factors? Any two terms have a common factor? First, you have to find which two terms have a common factor. Then, regroup the terms. Now, here see in the first two terms, B is a common factor. The last two terms, C is a common factor, 2 is also common factor. Why? Because here 2, here 12. 12 can be written as 2 into 6. Now, in the first two terms, let us factorize the first two terms. 6 a b minus b square can be written as b into b. Here we are grouping first two terms as a one subgroup, last two terms as a one subgroup. In the last two terms, see, third term has a symbol minus, fourth term has a symbol plus. So first let us interchange these two terms. Why? Because whenever if you are writing the algebraic expression, the algebraic expression should be positive term first. So I am writing 12ac first, next we can write minus 2bc. Now here we can take b common. What is the remaining? B is a common factor. What is the remaining factors? 6a minus, what is the remaining factor here? B. Plus, you can observe here, C is a common factor. Is there any other variable common factor? No. For the numbers, 2 is here, 2 is a factor. Here also 2 is a factor indirectly. Why? Because 12 can be written as 2 into 6. So 2, 6 are 12. So I am taking 2C common. So 2, 6 are 12. So 2 into 6. So what is the here remaining factor? 6. Variable A. So 2 and C common factor, remaining factor is B. Now let us write 6A minus B. 6A minus B is common factor. By taking 6A minus B common, what are the remaining? B plus 2C. So this is the method of factorization by grouping the terms. Now I will give you some problems. If you have doubt, ask me or send the photocopy. So you have to do these four problems. In these four problems, second, third, fourth have powers. So don't be confused. I will explain one problem, third one. See, a cube minus a square b square minus ab plus b cube. So can you find which two terms have a common factor? By taking first two terms, a cube a square, so a square is a common factor. Last two terms, b is a common factor. Now let us write here a square a cube. So here a square is there, so I am writing a cube as a into a square. A cube can be written as a into a square. Why? Because add the powers, 1 into 1 plus 2, 3 minus a square b square. Here again last two terms, again the first symbol is minus, second symbol is positive. Let us interchange these two terms, b cube minus ab. So here a square is a common factor. By taking a square common, a minus, what is the remaining factor? B square plus here b cube, here b. So b is a common factor. This b cube can be written as b into b square minus ab, a into b. Now this can be written as a square of a minus b square plus b is a common factor. Take b common, what is the remaining factors? B square minus a. So take a minus b square as a common factor. See, here a minus b square we got, here we got b square minus a. So this is not a common factor. So let us to get a minus b square here, see, here is a is positive symbol, here a is negative symbol. So let us take minus common. Whenever if you are multiplying with minus or taking minus common, the symbols will be changes. Here I am taking minus common, so this plus becomes minus, minus b of a minus a becomes plus a, plus b square becomes minus b square. Now see, a minus b square, a minus b square, a minus b square is common factor. So now next, what is a square minus b?